Let's have the man behind the vision, Rakesh sir, on stage, please. So first of all, congratulations on this beautiful film, sir. Sir, आप इस कॉज से बहुत जुड़े भी हुए हैं मैंने सुना
बहुत नहीं थोड़ा
सा सर सो वेयर डिड दिस आइडिया हैपन फॉर यू सर
आइडियाज मतलब फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर लग रहा है ट्रेलर के लिए फुल हाउस है भगवान करे फिल्म के लिए भी ऐसे ही हो जाए थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर कमिंग टुडे आई रियली मीन दैट Sunday is a non-working day, and aap sab aaye. Thank you very much. So, where do ideas come from? Ideas, wo bolne mein bada acha lagta hai ki mere ko aisa laga, maine aise socha, mere ko khayal aaya, but aisa kuch nahi hai. If we look at things around us, kya ho raha hai, kya chal raha hai, and we actually see them, and you start feeling them, to apne aap wo cheez bahar aa jati hai.
सर ये टाइटल
ये टाइटल ये मेरा नहीं है ये कन्हू का है ये बैठा है ओम ओम आपका नाम क्या है -10 क्या नाम है ओके इनको कैरेक्टर एम में रहने के लिए मैं रोज सुबह इनका नाम पूछता था और जो अपना रियल नाम बताता था उसको -10 इफ दे वुड बी इन द कैरेक्टर दे वुड गेट 100 points एंड एट 1000 points दे वुड विन अ प्राइज इनमें से कोई भी 1000 पे नहीं पहुंचा मेरे को छोड़ के
कन्हू बोल रहे हो पहुंचा
सो आई थिंक आई वाज शूटिंग फॉर भाग मिल्खा भाग 7-8 years ago एंड इट वाज अ लेट नाइट शिफ्ट वी फिनिश्ड 2-3 इन द मॉर्निंग एंड आई वाज टेकिंग द कार आउट वी वर कमिंग फ्रॉम आर्य मिल कॉलोनी एंड देयर इज अ सम स्लम कॉलोनी देयर तो एज द कार टर्न्ड द कॉर्नर द हेडलाइट्स हिट एंड सम A dozen odd women, they got up, pulling their sarees down, salwars up. To say, you can't put words to it. I can't say it was embarrassing, it was shocking, but that image kind of stayed with me, and that's the opening scene of the film also. That's how we open the film. At the same time, I got attached with a. NGO called Yuva Unstoppable and हमारा काम ही ये था कि हम स्कूल स्कूल में जाके वी मेक म्यूनिसिपल टॉयलेट्स तो फर्स्ट 2 years वर वेरी स्लो देन द नेक्स्ट 3 years द मोमेंटम पिक्ड अप सम वेरी गुड पीपल जॉइंड इन इन फैक्ट अम ब्रह्मस्मी मिस्टर अर्पित व्यास हु इज़ फाइनेंस द फिल्म इज़ वन ऑफ अ पेट्रंस एंड नाउ वी हैव 3 days ago वी फिनिश 1000 schools क्लोज टू 9000 toilets And smart classrooms and all that. But having said that, there's nothing to clap there. I haven't done anything. Nobody has done. This is not a toilet film. You see, when I came to Bombay, there was one Dharavi, and I've spoken to a few friends in the media earlier and. And I heard myself saying that we took a reverse pride in Dharavi. कि एशिया की सबसे बड़ी slum है $10 million का export होता है यहाँ से मतलब हम leather export करते हैं ये करते हैं वो करते हैं and एक film भी बनाई थी सुधीर मिश्रा ने called Dharavi and Nikon showed Dharavi and so many the cinema has always portrayed them. So there was this thing about entering this ghetto. Called Dharavi. Today, 30 years later, I had come to Bombay, but now it's Mumbai. Anyway, there are more than 100 Dharavis surrounding us. And the problem of women's safety is of alarming proportions. It's not a question of whether they have toilets or they don't have toilets, whether UNICEF says that 50% of the rapes happen when women go out to defecate. It is impossible to step out. And so a story had to be told. A story had to be told about this courageous girl called Sargam. All of 22, 24 years old, a single mother. Husband ran away when she got pregnant, when she was 17 years old. So she's brought up Kanhu. A story about Kanhu and his courage to see his mother's pain and feel it and not stop at anything, even if he has to knock the highest door of the establishment in the country. And he does everything, good things and bad things, including he tells the Prime Minister ki, in his letter, ki agar aapki maa ke saath aisa hota, toh aapko kaisa lagta? In a very innocent way. And when he's selling drugs and all that, just to bring safety for his mother, and mother is wild because she's brought up her only child, with great difficulty, of course, to say the least. And he's caught peddling drugs because his dear friends Ringtone and Nirala are selling Bombay Black every evening just to survive, not out of choice. There's an alpha in the group, Mangla or Saina, who suggests that ek hi aadmi solve kar sakta hai problem, uska naam hai Gandhi ji. Gandhi ji, she was referring to Gandhi in 500 rupee note, not the Gandhi we know. There's a beautiful character in Pappu, Pappu Pandey, played by Niteesh, his first film, who is in love with Sargam, and their love is of a different level altogether. And there's a new definition of romance. There's great neighborhood, which I learned when I was researching the film, that in our slums, actually, it's a big family. Everybody is helping everybody. So played by Nachiket and Rasika, and his Makran is not in the house today. He's played an amazing character again. He plays Mangla's father, and also the flip side of the coin. And so it's a milieu, and I learned a lot from the people there, how they come together, help each other. And but the distance between the haves and the haves not in the country, especially in a city like Bombay, which is giving 66% or so of the wealth to India, is shocking, absolutely shocking. The buildings are going higher and higher, and the slums are spreading all over the hills. In fact, if you ask anybody from anywhere in the world, their first impression of Mumbai when the plane is landing is to see the slums. It feels like you're going to land right in the middle of them. So you had to tell a story around that. It was very important. There's a seminal scene in the film when Ringtone and Kanhu, they're sitting on the pipeline. And there's a beautiful Pawai Lake, and there's Hiranandani out there. There's some 500 buildings. Lovely Hiranandani, all of us want a flat there. So you remember that scene? Aja.
The star is here, Kanhu, come.
Pakka yadan. Baito. Action.
यार कनु क्या कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे
यार गिनती कर उसमें कितने फ्लोर्स होंगे
नहीं मालूम तू बता
500 और हर फ्लोर पे दो टॉयलेट
तुझे कैसे मालूम
कब से यही तो कर रहा हूँ और हर रूम में दो टॉयलेट्स और एक फ्लोर पे 10 कोली होंगी 2 BHK
मतलब एक एक फ्लोर पे 20 टॉयलेट
मतलब एक एक फ्लोर पे 20 टॉयलेट
मैं थोड़ी सा बताऊं भूल गया कोई नहीं
सो थैंक यू वेरी मच सो हीरानंदानी देख रहे हैं वो कहते हैं वो बिल्डिंग गेन उसमें माले गेन कितने माले होते दोनों में बोला तो एक फ्लोर पे 20 कोली होगी 2 BHK एक फ्लोर पे मतलब 10 फ्लैट में 20 टॉयलेट तो ऐसी तो 50 माले की बिल्डिंग है 1000 टॉयलेट पीछे देख पीछे है इनका गांधीनगर का स्लम, साला लाखों लोगों की बस्ती और एक भी टॉयलेट नहीं. एंड दे बर्स्ट आउट लाफिंग ऑन दैट. सो समवेयर द फिल्म इज नॉट पॉइंटिंग अ फिंगर एट ऑल. आई डिडंट वांट टू पॉइंट अ फिंगर. ऑल द टाइम वी कीप ब्लेमिंग द सिस्टम, द सोसाइटी, दो दे दीज क्वेश्चंस डू कम अप. बट दिस गैंग, दे टेक अप थिंग्स इन देयर ओन हैंड and they do something about it. So the idea is about their character emerges because they make choices, very difficult choices, and that's why they are the real heroes of the film. Film ke bare mein kafi baat ho gayi, aap dekhenge, aapko aur shayad acha lage. So while Arpit bhai gave the money, Yuva Unstoppable was right there as an NGO helping us out. We had the film. So now we wanted a partner to bring the film to the people and take it to the world at large. Film banana ek cheez hai aur usko logo tak le jana usse 10 times more difficult cheez hai. Aap aaj jo hum sab baithe hain ये उसी कड़ी में एक मतलब दिस इज वन चैप्टर इन दैट वी आर ट्राइंग टू ऑल ऑफ अस नाउ. आई बिलीव द यूनिवर्स कंस्पायर्स, आई होपिंग ऑल ऑफ अस कंस्पायर टू टेक द फिल्म फर्दर. एंड देन आउट ऑफ द ब्लू वन मॉर्निंग आई कॉल जयंती भाई एंड आई सेड जयंती भाई चाय पिलाएंगे, ही सेड आ जाओ. सो आई वेंट ओवर टू हिम and just spoke to him about the film for 5 minutes. And he said, ye hum kar rahe hain. He called his team, acha inki story suno, kitne print hone chahiye aur kaise hame release karni chahiye, ye film humko bahut pyar se aage le jani padegi, isme hum jaldi nahi karenge. To when do you want to release it? So I said, jab marzi, mera kaam ho gaya, abhi aapka kaam shuru hota hai. So on this note, Jayanti bhai, please come up. And I have worked with the greatest of studios, you name them, in India and abroad, and some of the best producers. But so much fun I have not had what I am having with Jayanti bhai, because our decision making is 30 seconds away. He believes, most importantly, see, we say he's put his hard-earned money behind the film, but actually he believes in the film. And that's what is so reassuring for all of us who have made this film happen. So, Jayanti bhai, please.
Thank you, Rakesh ji.
Thank you, Jayanti bhai.
Rakesh ji ne kuch zyada hi bol diya. Waisa kuch hai nahi. Rakesh ji ke saath kaam karna hi bahut badi baat hai. Kyunki inhone itni sundar film banayi hai. Aur isko aage leke jane ke liye humari kismat hai. Uske liye Rakesh ji ko thanks.
Are nahi, aapko thanks. There are two very, very special characters in this film. Actually, two very special characters in life, if you look at things. Sargam and Kanhu. Sargam plays a single mother. Anjali, I have to embarrass you, sorry. But every time I said action, I would forget to say cut. Because, and at times even walk into the frame, just enjoying what was going on there. And I never knew that the words written on the page could come alive with so much passion, with so much force. And I won't say we had a tough time shooting the film. We really enjoyed it. It was a tough location. We had a share of fights every 2.5 minutes. But those were wonderful discussions. Thank you, Anjali. Please.
Anjali, please join us on stage, please.
So you can see this. Now you have to speak to her. Grill her.
Anjali, hi. So what was Rakesh's takya kalam on sets?
I don't remember actually. Like, every day there would be something or the other. But my story with Rakesh sir and his films would go very, very long. It would begin with my days in Pune University Drama School. I was studying in Pune University Drama School, and Rang De Basanti was released. And one of our friend had an iPod thingy, and he had the album on it. And we were coming from Manipur back to Pune, and it was a long train ride from Kolkata. And all I could do is I would give him money, because he was not, like, I wanted to listen to every song again and again. And he was like, that's it. Once it's done. And then I said, okay, I'm going to give you some money, like 10 rupees per hour or something like that. And I made a deal with him, and I listened to every single track like for the entire time we reached to Pune. So that was then. Then I was in National School of Drama. Then Delhi 6 was released. And by that time, I could afford an MP3 player. So I had my own MP3 player, and I was listening to the songs and walking and visualizing all the songs again. And then 2014, when sir received the National Award for Bhag Milkha Bhag, I was there for the Telugu film, and I saw him in the next lane. And I was like, you know, I was like, oh, there he is. And I was like, okay, cool. I don't have the courage to go and say hi to him, but okay, I just saw him. A few years later, Mirzia happened. We met. And then exactly 3rd May 2017, we started shooting after, it was the same day when I saw him in Delhi during the National Awards. And the same day I started shooting for Mere Pyare Prime Minister. So I always say that there are no accidents in life. His style of narration has impacted myself as an actor, director, artist a lot. So for me, it was more than a dream come true to work with him. We worked on the script for more than 2 months. We were working on the script almost every day. We would come, chat, have discussion. How would she speak? What would be her language? The choices of words, all the details. And it's a privilege to get to work on the script on this level, because we are so used to fast food, fast entertainment, everything, you know, fast. We just want everything fast. We don't want to work. So here with him, you get to work. So this is hard work from every single person. He pampered a lot. He pampered all of us, all the actors, especially them. But beautiful in a way, because where we were shooting in Ghatkopar, by the end of the shoot, every day we would just go, and we never felt there is this person from the crew and this person where I'm just sitting to have, like, in the house. We would sit in the house and we would do the makeup or change the costume. But the auntie in the house she eventually became part of the crew. So there was no difference between these are the crew people and these are the people who live there. So we all became like a big family. That's about it. Thank you, sir.
There are no thank yous at all. Hard work and the way we shot the film, technically I'm going is, I'm a great fan of shooting the entire scene in one single shot. And then later, if required, so this Holi song you see is 8.5 minute single shot. Every scene has been shot in a single shot. And then if you think you need another angle, so you have to understand what the actors, Anjali, Om, Nishu, Nachi, Sanya, Prasad, Adarsh, how you, what you brought in, and Rasika, she's not here, of course, Makran. And they were totally into it. There was never a thing about ye line hai, wo line hai. I would like to call Kanhu, Kanhaiya. Pyar se log mujhe Kanhu bulate hain. Vaise mera naam Om hai. And look at him. Lovely. Ab dikh rahe hain.
Kanhu, Om bulaun, Kanhu bulaun, Kanhaiya bulaun. Kanhu bulaun. All right, chalo, mujhe minus 10 nahi milega. Right, Kanhu, ek aisa din set ka mujhe yaad dila jab tujhe line yaad hi nahi ho rahi thi ya ho bhi rahi thi aur Rakesh sir tujhe leke gaye kone mein bola ki dekh beta, aaj to tujhe ye line puri karni hi hongi.
Nahi, aisa koi din nahi tha. Sir atta marwate the humko sets pe.
सबसे ज्यादा कौन सा सीन शूट करने में मजा आया तुझे? कनु, सबसे ज्यादा सीन शूट करने में कौन सा मजा आया था?
मुझे सबसे ज्यादा मजा आया था, वैसे तो हर सीन में शूट करने में बहुत मजा आता था.
ट्रू आर्टिस्ट.
फिर भी
ऐसा कोई सीन नहीं था जिसमें कुछ ज्यादा मजा आ गया. सब सीन में बहुत मजा आते थे.
ये भी बात है, तभी वो पूरी फिल्म में लग रहा है कि एक हर एक फिल्म में, हर एक सीन में पहले वाले सीन से ज्यादा मजा आ रहा
है. जब मजा बढ़ते जाता था.
जब भागने वाला सीन था, सर ने बोला था कि मिल्खा से इंस्पिरेशन लेना जो तू भागा था वहां पे.
नहीं,
बट अ फैंटास्टिक जॉब करो.
थैंक यू.
यू नो, एब्सोल्युटली इट्स I remember Anjali saying something to me towards, I don't know if you remember, towards the, when the film was 50%, 60% over. And it was very intense, it was very emotional. And we were all giving ourselves completely emotionally to each other, because it wouldn't have been possible otherwise. And she said, you know, I never knew this part of the femininity was also something like that, and she had touched upon that. On this note, I would like to call Nishu up. It's his first film. Nishu came all the way, wanted to learn acting, and then he disappeared for a couple of years, went to Strasbourg and learned his method acting. Came back and didn't want to make a film unless he got the right story. He sprinkled gold dust all over the film, has stayed outside, never tried to come and step on anybody. And for the first time, Nishu, I'm telling you, I think you've done a good job, yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Good afternoon, everybody.
Most grand way to get thing for you. I mean, certification ho chuki aaj Nishu ki.
I think this is one of the biggest days in my life. My first film and trailer launch, yeah.
I can see that on your face.
Yeah.
Housey lagti hai logo ki. It's literally like that. How was your experience working with Rakesh?
Well, my experience was beautiful. It's been an honor to work with him in my first film. I've been trying to work with him for a very long time because I love all his films. And especially working with Anjali, who is such a talented actor and she's won so many awards. So working with her was amazing. And these kids were amazing, awesome. We had a ball on the set. I mean, we were in Ghatkopar on the hill. We didn't have any vanity vans. We were changing in rooms that they lived in. And these kids and us, we had a ball. We actually had a ball, yeah.
One of the most memorable days of the shoot would be?
Actually, my first day, which was the first day of shoot. And I was so nervous. I am right now as well. And the first scene, I had to sing a song starting in the film. And, you know, yeah, that was the best day. I mean, that was very nervous.
How many takes?
I don't know, sir, would remember. I think 3-4.
One take, usse zyada time nahi hota. No, I was completely blessed. Some people who are not here is my mentor and father figure, Gulzar Bhai, whose writing is always special. I started my career with him on Aksshay and moving on to Mirzia, we created a lovely album. But with Mere Pyare Prime Minister, I think the best compliment I got was from Meghna Gulzar. And she says, this is completely unfair. He gives you the best. And she was really angry because I went to hear her songs for Razi. And I played my songs, and Gulzar Bhai was there, and she said, I'm not talking to you, and she walked out of the room. So he's done, and Shankar, Ehsan, and Loy, they are soulmates, and they have put in so many hours, day and night, all the time, calling me up, we have this idea, and there are only 4 songs in the film. So, and each song had to take the story forward. And their beautiful voices. Shankar and Shivam have sung a song for the first time together. In the history of Indian cinema, I think Kishore Kumar and Amit Kumar have not sung a song. Nitin Mukesh haven't sung a song. S.G. Burman, R.D. Burman haven't sung a song. But Shankar and Shivam have sung a duo. Arijit has a lovely song, the title song. Rekha Bhardwaj has sung amazing lullaby. There is an ode in the film to the greatest filmmaker. Everybody has their choices. For V. Shantaram, I've grown up on watching his cinema. I happened to see him. I used to shoot a lot in Rajkamal, at times have very little conversation. He was a man of few words, but his cinema said everything. So this is my ode to him. We are also on the eve of Holi, so a beautiful Holi song. On this note, I think we have to have Sanya, Adarsh, Ringtone, Nirala, please come up, Mangla, and Nachi, please. Nachi Ket, yes. Yeah. And, each film, we've heard this, it sounds very boring, we all give in a lot, everybody works hard, everybody tries to make the best film in the world, but each film takes out something from you. And the person it took out the most is right here, our producer Bharati. Please, Bharati. So, you have to... Why me?
Yeah. Hi, Bharati.
Hi.
So, what part of the journey would you like to take us through today?
I think it all starts with the story. I'm somebody who likes to know what story we want to tell. And then, of course, everybody else conspires to make that story happen. And I think the best part of filmmaking is that when we have 100 minds, 1,000 minds coming to make one piece of communication, and that connects to millions of hearts, that's the best part for me. So for me, it starts with, So that's the best part that I enjoy in the whole process.
Nachiket, jab phone aaya ki aap film ke liye select ho gaye hain, Rakesh Omprakash sir, director hain, toh what was that feeling?
Wo pehle se feeling shuru ho hi gayi thi, matlab select ho gaye hain, is phone ke pehle hi shuru ho gayi thi. To असली मजा उसके बाद अब इस पल तक आ ही रहा है मतलब और अब देखेंगे हम
वाव लवली यार आप लोगों को कैसा लगा काम करके इस फिल्म पे बताइए मुझे
बहुत अच्छा लगा सर के साथ काम करने के बाद और सर ने पूरी फिल्म में हमें कहीं पे भी स्क्रिप्ट नहीं दी हमें कहीं पे भी सब इम्प्रोवाइज था हमें स्क्रिप्ट मिली ही नहीं थी और वर्कशॉप में तो बहुत मजा आए और पूरी फिल्म तो mind-blowing.
Abhi lifelong tujhe log ringtone banane wale hain. Are you ready for this name? Kuch batana chahenge aap hame ringtone? Ki aap kitne acche se baje is film mein? Isne kya kya kiya set pe?
Isne mics giraye toilet ke andar.
The toilet. और इसने जब ये कर रहा था अपना बिजनेस तो इसने माइक ही गिरा दिया अंदर.
और ये खुशी खुशी आके दे भी रहा था, सर माइक गिर गया. सर ने बोला वेरी गुड.
बोल दे बोल दे, जो बोलना है बोल दे.
मुझे फिल्म बहुत अच्छी लगी.
उसका ऐसे ही है फिल्म. He had many dialogues, but वो जो भी अपना बोलता था, that was okay. He would change the entire scene the way he wanted.
Authenticity है उसमें. All right, we'll take a group photo now, and we shall proceed with the media questions after that.
Oh yeah, we
saw.
Who all from the crew is here? Sorry, I can't see.
Abhu.
Oh, Abhilasha, Manjula, Rajatta. Yo, please. I have to, there's a special word for Rajatta because we shot the film in real locations, absolutely in the slums. And for the first time, I was surprised when he found the location, we went there. So I said, kya karoge? He says, sab ready hai, tum shoot karo, mera isme kuch kaam nahi hai. But then he would do his magic, and that used to be really great magic. Yeah. Awesome. And Abhilasha, hi. Hi, guys.
Kanhu, Kanhu ki mummy, Jayanti sir and Rakesh sir will be on stage. Acha, photograph with the cast and Rakesh sir. Nachi. We'll start with the Q&A. Only StarCast picture, only StarCast. Arunaji, once more.
Hello.
Hello. My question is to Rakesh sir. Straight sir. Pooja. Pooja, you're from India News sir. So last year I remember taking your interview in the slum areas of Ghatkopar, and looking at the location, I'm sure there was a lot of research done and efforts were taken. So firstly, congratulations. The trailer is very interesting and it sends a good social message across the audiences. And this is soon after Akshay Kumar's Toilet film. So do you think there will this film will bring a big change in India?
I don't think you make films for change. You tell stories because you feel you want to express something. So it's not about change. And this is, once again, it's not a film about toilets. I'm happy that there was a movie called Toilet Ek Prem Katha, and people are picking up very unique subjects. But this is a film which we need to feel for the women, and to say that it's for their safety will be belittling it. It is hame jo hamari mansikta hai, the consciousness needs a shift as to how we look at women, and I think it's something more than just slum, safety, toilet. It's not that. Yeah.
Rakesh ji. Yeah. फिल्म में माँ बेटे की कहानी है तो उनकी केमिस्ट्री के लिए आपको क्या क्या करना पड़ा था
क्योंकि मेरे को इतना सोचना पड़ रहा है तो जाहिर है कि कुछ भी नहीं करना पड़ा था जो किया इन्होंने ही किया और आप ही बताओ क्या किया आप दोनों ने प्लीज
अंजलि प्लीज
झगड़ा किया बहुत झगड़ा तो करते थे नहीं एक्चुअली जब स्क्रिप्ट पे काम शुरू हुआ तब भी और जब हम मिले और वर्कशॉप्स हुई एक बात कहीं थी अंदर जो दैट दिस इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू बी अ टिपिकल मदर एंड सन रिलेशनशिप दे आर गोइंग टू बी फ्रेंड्स ये दोस्त हैं क्योंकि उसकी ज़िंदगी में यही है और उसकी ज़िंदगी में है उसके दोस्त बट फॉर सरगम ही कनु इज़ हर बेस्ट फ्रेंड एंड ऑल्सो वाइस वर्सा तो बहुत ही इक्वल रिलेशनशिप था ऐसा नहीं था कि मेरा बच्चा है या उम्र से कम है तो यू नो इक्वल था नथिंग मोर देन दैट और क्या
नहीं आई थिंक वेरी वेल पुट इफ यू गेट प्रेग्नेटेड एट 16 एंड गिव बर्थ एट 17 यू विल ओनली ब्रिंग अप अ फ्रेंड नॉट जस्ट अ चाइल्ड एंड ऑल अलोन इफ यू आर डूइंग दैट तो बहुत गिव एंड टेक होता है स्पेशली इफ यू आर नॉट प्रोवाइडेड फॉर उसके साथ आपको यहाँ मतलब सर्वाइव भी करना है हम सब सर्वाइव करते हैं आपको मालूम है कितना डिफिकल्ट है सो इट दैट रिलेशनशिप वॉज ब्यूटिफुल एंड आई थिंक कैमरे के आगे इतना नहीं था जितना कैमरे के पीछे इनकी केमिस्ट्री डेवलप हुई थी सो ऑलवेज गिविंग अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू ईच अदर सो मेनी थिंग्स वो ऑर्गेनिकली हुआ था इतना कुछ प्लान था नहीं उसमें
और ये आपकी पहली फिल्म है जिसमें आपने बच्चों से काम करवाया है तो उनके साथ उनसे काम निकलवाने का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा था
देखिए ये बहुत बड़ी गलतफहमी है इन्होंने मेरे से काम निकलवाया ऐसा कहीं से भी नहीं है मैंने इनसे काम निकलवाया इन सब ने मिलके मेरे से बहुत काम निकलवाया मेरे से बहुत मेहनत करवाई है और मैंने इतनी मेहनत कभी नहीं की जितनी इन्होंने करवाई है और एसेंशली मैंने कभी इनको ये नहीं बोला कैसे करना है ये जाते थे अपना एट बेस्ट माय रोल एज अ डायरेक्टर वाज यू नो एक फुटबॉल का मैच शुरू हो जाता है ना तो जो मैनेजर होता है या कोच होता है वो बाहर ही बैठा रहता है फील्ड से वो अंदर जाके खेल नहीं सकता अंदर इन सब का हुनर था कैसे बॉल को टैकल करें कैसे पास करें एक दूसरे को कैसे गोल मारें और कोई आउट ऑफ कैरेक्टर जाता था तो मैं सीटी बजा देता था कि मतलब ऑफ साइड
आई रिमेंबर लाइक ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट विजिट्स लाइक वंस आई वेंट विद द क्रू व्हेन सर वाज हैविंग लोकेशन रेकी पे एंड आई केम वी हैड टू लाइक क्लाइंब अप द हिल एंड देन कम डाउन वी केम डाउन एंड आई वाज लाइक आई एम फीलिंग लिटिल You know, I was troubled. I was troubled with this thing that how not to have this, that we are going there in that location, in that area with our, you know, expensive cameras, and we are trying to be part of that landscape, and how to get rid of this thought that we are coming from some point of view, some position, with all these expensive equipments and whatever. So I was troubled with that. And I said this to him. I was like, I don't know how to, you know, gel. Like, I don't know how to dissolve this knot. So he said, it's not that, you know, it's about celebration as well. These people, like, they're living there, so that means there is heaviness. We are putting the heaviness on it, that, okay, they're living there, blah, blah, blah. So it's about celebration. This film is about celebration. And that kind of stuck, that stayed with me throughout. And that's what we saw also when we were shooting. And also between this relationship, between my friend, my neighbor friend, everyone, his friends. So there was always this one thing of celebration that, okay, we are celebrating. Even if it's a small meal we are eating with khichdi, it's a celebration. So that's something that stayed also in this relationship and overall in everything what we were doing.
Jayanti sir, straight over here. So what made you change the release date of the film? It was supposed to release on 8th and now it is releasing on 15th. So
ye release ka plan pehle 8 March hi tha, lekin hamare paas ek film aayi Red Chili se jo hamare friend ki hai Sujoy Ghosh badla, wo hum 8 March ko release kar rahe hain. To humne ek hi team hamari kaam karegi dono picture pe, to hame laga jaise Rakesh ji ne bataya ye bahut aaram se film release karne wali thi. इसलिए हमने बोला कि हम ही सेटल कर लेते हैं, तो एक वीक पुश किया हमने.
रकेश जी, कैन यू हियर मी?
या
सी, आई रिमेंबर दैट वन फिल्म ऑफ राज कपूर साहब, दैट यू नो अब दिल्ली दूर नहीं. तो हैव यू टेकन सम इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम दैट फिल्म? और बिकॉज यू नो देयर एज अ मैसेज गोस, यू नो, अब मेरी अर्जी सुन लो जरा. तो इज इट लाइक दैट? बिकॉज यू नो रेफरेंस वाइज यू must have shot this film because the children are going to approach PM. So something like that we can see, we can think of that.
Main kaan pakadne padenge mereko. Wo that's one of the greatest films ever made for, yes, on Indian cinema.
Yes, yes.
Ab dilli dur nahi, boot polish, jaagte raho. But so yes, I have taken a lot of inspiration.
But you also good, you are also very good filmmaker, we know that also.
No,
that.
No, not really.
I know, yes.
Beside the point, so in my growing up years, yes. There was one television in the neighborhood.
Yeah, yeah.
जो फिर वो खिड़की खोल देते थे, हमारी पुरानी दिल्ली में ऐसे ही होता था.
yes.
जो सबसे बड़ा मकान होता था, और फिर सब भीड़ भाड़ लग जाती थी. एंड आई रिमेंबर अब दिल्ली दूर नहीं और बूट पॉलिश एंड ऑल, वही रिपीट होती रहती थी एवरी संडे. एंड वी ग्रोन अप ऑन दोज फिल्म्स एंड टू ऑब्वियसली दे आर इंस्पिरेशन.
Great.
And Do Aankhe Bara Haath and Bandari and all the Pyasa Kagaz Ke Phool, they are all part of a collective consciousness, which now will change is clothes and come in the cinema today, or people who've grown up with that cinema.
I do agree with you, because in the audiences change, the people, those who have gone at that age, you know, I mean, the times have changed now. So certainly you can take inspiration, and you can make topically, you know, you can make. It's a very good topic, I know that. Jayantilal, can you say, tell me, because you regularly keep on releasing films, or this is very simple narration film, I believe, because it's a realistic, short and realistic locations. So kya aap is film se business ki kya umeed aapki kaisi, aur kitna aap bade way mein isko karenge, because aap to bade bade film distribute bhi karte ho.
Business ka to har film ka alag hota hai. और उससे पहले तो ये बोलना चाहिए कि कंटेंट अच्छा है और कंटेंट को बैक करना चाहिए. बिजनेस की उम्मीद तो वैसे भी बॉक्स ऑफिस हम लोग बाद में ही देखते हैं कि जो होगी, रिलीज़ अच्छी होनी चाहिए सबसे पहले. और राकेश जी की फिल्म में ये बॉक्स ऑफिस में अच्छी गई है, ऐसा भी नहीं है. तो मुझे लगता है कि ये जो हमारे पास विंडो है वो ओपन विंडो है, 15 मार्च को कोई फिल्म नहीं है, तो बहुत अच्छा बिजनेस करेगी.
Mr. Mehra, towards your left, Justin here from PTI, here. Mr. Mehra, are there plans, perhaps set in motions, to have a special screening for the PM to see the film?
No, not at all. We don't have any such plans yet, but yeah, it's kind of become very fashionable to do that. So I would rather want to stay away from that.
Why? I mean, is there a particular reason?
Now you are going after it. You asked something, I very, very honestly replied to you. No, there are no whys. I feel the film is made for the people of the country, and somewhere I don't want to dilute that and use such a huge, such a big office. He's a very, very busy man and running the country, to take 3 hours of his time, which he could, I think, devote to some national and international policy. Just because I want to promote a film, wo mere ko kuch judge nahi raha. Haan, agar unka dekhne ka man hua, to it will be an honor. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Hello, Rakesh.
Mr. Mehra, this is Priyanka.
Hi. Towards your right.
Hi, Priyanka.
Oh, okay, hi. This is Priyanka from Indian Express. I wanted to ask you that, you know, you've worked with so many stars, from Mr. Bachchan to Aamir, and in this film you're working with these wonderful children, but who were more difficult to handle as a director, those like big stars or these kids?
Anjali.
Why so?
Woman.
Anjali, do you have anything to say on that?
No, I have nothing to say. I take everything. Whatever he says, yes, I was trouble. I was a big trouble.
Right.
No, I've been completely very, very fortunate. My first film, when I stepped into it, and I always say that Amitji was there and he gave birth to a director. And if you see, there was Amitji, then it became Aamir, then became Abhishek, then became Farhan, then became Harsh, and now it's Om and Anjali. So age group choti hoti jaa rahi. So there must be some reason. Abhi wapas shuru karna padega.
Hello, Rakesh sir. Straight ahead over here.
Yeah.
Sir, a little to your left.
Yeah.
Yeah. Russell here from Movified. What I would want to know, it seems that the film has been shot in a lot of real life locations. And you're shot in a lot of slums, it seems like. So what was that experience like in a shooting in a raw and a rough and gritty environment like that?
It was not shot in a lot of real location. It was only shot on real locations. And it was only shot in real homes. We didn't even create a set for the interiors. Now what happens is, in a situation like this, yes, a crew has to, they have to adjust a lot. Spatially is very challenging for the DOP, but nobody wants to compromise on the work. So they would put lights in very odd positions, and you can imagine if there's a 10 feet by 15 feet room and you're doing a night scene, quite a few night scenes in the film. What it is actually very difficult is for the actors, you know, because they cannot show that discomfort. We can still be behind the camera and cursing ourselves and sweating and be in all kind of moods, but they have to stay in that character. They cannot let that environment affect them. So I think it was really, really very, very challenging for the actors to pull this off, and hats off to them, absolutely.
Also, sir, you said that one day while riding back after shooting Bhag Milka Bhag, you saw this site and you got an idea to make this film. But what about the characters? Because the characters look so authentic. Did you base it on some real life people?
No, I didn't get the idea to make that film. That stayed in my subconscious. You know, I'm from an Air Force school, Balbati Air Force in Delhi. And every day when I used to enter the school, there was a MiG-21 plane there. 20 years, 30 years later in life, MiG-21s are crashing. So it moved me, and I made Rang De Basanti, and I saw this thing. So this storyline is not mine, it belongs to Manoj. He brought the storyline, and then Hussein collaborated, and both of us took it further. And from a simple storyline, which is beautiful, that this kid writes a letter to the Prime Minister, we took it to the next level, built it around, got the rape in, got the holy factor in, got revolved everything around the mother and son, and got a beautiful, a third kind of a romance into it. Can, in a place like this, can there be a very progressive kind of romance? Not the cliché definition of boy-girl romance. Can there be something more? Can there be soulmates? And do you actually have to be married to be romantic? Can and stuff like that. And then, most importantly, the spirit, what Anjali was talking about. You know, kids are amazing because every day they're discovering something new in life. So I started seeing the film through their eyes also a lot, because for them it was wonderful. So yeah, all that.
Hi, Anjali, straight towards you. Anjali, looking at your filmography and especially your Hindi filmography, you have mostly associated yourself with movies that, you know, either have a strong social subtext or, you know, have an artistic bend towards them. Is it something very, you're very conscious about selecting scripts, you know, which reflect, you know, this zone of cinema, or are you looking forward to doing like all sorts of even mainstream Bollywood masala, all of that? So just about that, I wanted to ask you.
See, these answers will keep changing, you know, like every day the answers change with all of us. Like we think that we are that yesterday and today we are something else. So a simple answer to this is when I fought with my family to get into a drama school when I was 16, nobody paid me, you know, it was my choice. I ran away from my my home, from Nashik, to study, to become an artist, because that's what I wanted to become. And then I studied, and then I studied more, and then I got into films. I studied direction for a while in National School of Drama. Then films just happened, and it opened up a different artist. It gave me a different medium. And then the film kind of happened to me, and I went along with it. So choices are, of course, made consciously, unconsciously, especially with the subject, because I remember saying this to Rakesh sir as well, and also to myself, to know the fact that one day on a set is something where I give my breath. You know, I'm breathing there. I'm giving my sweat. I'm living that one day on the set. So I want to be on a set. I want to be around the people. Forget the set. Forget the work. I want to be in situations in life where I really want to be. Like, you know, this is part of my life. This is part of your life. We are sharing life right now in this moment. So it better be good. It better be, you know, whatever. So that's with work. My work is my life, and the life is work. It's both ways. I don't know if I answered your question. So if the Bollywood masala thing becomes part of my life, if I feel that, okay, I'll have fun doing it, I will, or I don't know. The answers keep changing. Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Rakesh, so I had a small question for you. You know, like when we do even simple Google searches on the plight of open defecation in India, often we come across these statements that come from either the municipal bodies or the chief minister or the government itself that, you know, Mumbai has become open defecation free, and even rural and urban Maharashtra, you know, this problem doesn't exist, which renders your film completely fictional, although people over here living here will have very different anecdotes and reality issues to share. And it's kind of ironic that, you know, the people who are responsible for it are claiming it doesn't exist, and there's this attitude of denial, while cinema, which is a fictional medium, has to take the job of showing us reality. So how do you feel about that?
What's the question?
My question is that, you know, there's this attitude of denial, especially with the issue of open defecation. We've had statements made at separate occasions previous year that it's not a problem, that it doesn't exist, and we are very near, the state is very near to, you know, eradicating this problem very completely. So do you agree with that? Because obviously your film points to a very different reality.
Come on.
Thank you so much.
That's right, the answer.
Hello, Rakesh
last
sir?
Question.
Yeah, Rakesh sir.
No, it doesn't fly like that. It's not that. And a lot of my friends here from the media have been to the location where we shot. One of our locations, you know, when those four of them are sitting in that location on top of the hill where the planes cross you, we would shoot every day, and for a couple, like 1 week of schedule was on top of the hill. And I still remember this 90-year-old or 95-year-old lady who was back was completely bent, would climb up on the hill from, because her Kohli was there, and would walk from here to here. It would take her like 10 minutes to walk, and we would stop shooting. And she was going to defecate there on the top of the hill. So I don't think, and once again, this film is not about open defecation. That's not my job. My job is to somewhere touch you and touch myself, because I felt like that is how to change this consciousness towards women and their safety. Whether rapes happen while they're defecating, you take a plot point, so you have to weave a story around it. But overall, it's just an open reality out there. Is the question of forcing yourself on somebody else if you're physically stronger. I don't think if you're not physically stronger, you could have done that any other way. So it's I won't even insult the animals. People say it's animalistic behavior. I don't think even animals behave like that.
Rakesh, sir, you have built more than 100 toilets in a slum area. Did you get any political help? And elections are coming near. So, mere pyare Prime Minister, aapko kya lagta hai, kitna impactful rahega? Ye film kitni impactful rehne wali hai audiences pe, aur kitna effect karegi elections pe?
Nahin, kuch bhi nahin effect karegi. Right. Karna bhi nahin chahiye. Filmon ka kaam hi nahin hai ki wo elections pe impact kare. एक जब कोई एक फिल्म बनती है वो हाँ जाहिर है कि वो इट शुड डू वेरी वेल ऑन द फ्राइडे एंड द कमिंग फ्राइडेज एंड होल्ड इटसेल्फ एंड गिव द मनी बैक टू द इन्वेस्टर्स बट माय एंडेवर हैज टू मेक मूवीज विच कैन बी परपेचुअल कैन यू नो बिकॉज हम सबकी बेस्ट नॉवेल्स बेस्ट गाने बेस्ट फिल्में हम ये थोड़ी बोलते हैं मैंने वो उस हफ्ते में देखा था उस हफ्ते में सुना था अब हमें कुछ नहीं मालूम वो फिल्म 1960 में बनी थी 70 में बनी थी 80 में 90 में बट वो हमारी प्यारी फिल्में हैं सो कहीं अगर आप वो क्लब में आप बहुत लकी हुए और सब कुछ अच्छा हो गया और वो उस क्लब में एंटर हो गए जहां आपका काम परपेचुअल हो जाता है तो मेरे ख्याल से कामयाबी वहां वो कामयाबी भी बहुत ज़रूरी है
Alright, thank you so much. So that brings us to the end of the Q&A round. And thank you. Please do enjoy the film on the 15th. Thank you, Rakesh sir. Thank you, Jayanti sir. Anjali, Natu, and you, congratulations.
Can we see the trailer once more?
Yes, why not, sir? Once more.